Mumbai is officially the noisiest city in the country, according to the Central Pollution Control Board, and India is clearly one of the noisiest countries in the world. WHO has also found that various correlations between noise and health, including hearing loss, mental health, blood pressure, heart disease, loss of productivity, lack of sleep-related ailments. Mumbai is also a very densely packed city. So one person making noise can actually disturb hundreds of people at a time, or even thousands of people, depending on the location.
It started as voluntary work on noise pollution. But over the last two decades, it has turned into a crusade for Sumaira Abdulali. Today, she is perhaps the biggest champion against noise pollution in the city. It all began in 2002. With Abdulali filing a public interest litigation in the Bombay High Court. A year later, the first court order banning loudspeakers in silent zones was passed, marking the beginning of what has been a long but deeply rewarding journey.
People started calling me once the press reported it and published my number. People started calling me, and the kind of emotion that I felt and heard in them, people were crying on the phone, people were saying, even if you can't help us, just the fact that you're listening to us is enough for us. That's what really, I think, was really my inspiration.
It was through Sumaira's efforts in her own capacity, as well as through Awaaz Foundation, that noise pollution started getting the kind of attention it had always warranted. But it wasn't an easy job for a lone activist.
The first thing that we realized was that there was no data at all. So there were noise rules with specified decibel levels which had to be maintained, but nobody knew what the decibel levels actually were. And so the very first court order, in fact, just said that noise should be kept at a reasonably low level because there was no way of quantifying it. So I realized that I have to generate the data myself, and I was lucky someone donated a noise meter to me. I took that meter and I just did it myself. Now with the advent of technology, every person can have a decibel meter on their phone. It's a free app, a free download, and Mumbaikars are using this free app. People are now complaining using decibel readings on their phone.
Awaaz Foundation's noise pollution campaigns have found overwhelming support from Mumbaikars and are now, in fact, spreading to other cities in the country. As the foundation is an unfunded NGO, Sumaira Abdulali asks people to contribute their own resources to make their city a better place to live in. Her painstaking efforts over the past two decades perhaps finally paid off.
I was very worried because I've been here doing it myself for 18 years, but I found that everybody stepped up, nothing suffered, the noise readings went on as usual. In fact, the government also did more than usual. They did their readings, the police did a good job. There were numerous complaints from citizens and nothing suffered. So I'm really very happy because that means that it's no longer dependent on me as an individual. It is actually a people's movement.